Welcome to the dbForge Studio for Postgres tutorials. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a Postgres connection. On the first run of the application, without previously created connections to Postgres or Postgres local servers, the connections will be added automatically. You just need to specify the connection parameters in the Database Connection Properties window. Here, specify a database host, either an IP address or a domain name. Next, enter a username and password. From the drop-down list, choose the database you want to connect to and clear the Show All Databases checkbox to view only the selected database. After that, click Test Connection and then click Connect. The connection to the selected database will appear in the Database Explorer. To view the connection properties, right-click the connection and select Properties on the shortcut menu. Now let's create another database connection to the server. You can do it by clicking the New Connection button on the toolbar or in Database Explorer. In the window that opens, enter a username and password, select the default database, and press Enter. The connection is created. Now let's enable the Show All Databases option. When you first run dbForge Studio without the previously created connections, but with the installed local database servers, connections to local servers will automatically be added to the Database Explorer. To open the connections you've created, enter the password. To modify the connection properties, click Modify Connection on the shortcut menu and switch to the Advanced tab in the Database Connection Properties window that will appear. Here, you can configure additional properties. Connection timeout means that you can specify the required period of time after which Studio stops trying to get the server's response to open the connection. Execute timeout means that you can specify the required period of time after which Studio stops trying to execute the query. Keep in mind that 0 sets the infinite wait time. If data is displayed incorrectly, set Unicode character encoding. After that, verify the connection and refresh Database Explorer. The data will be displayed correctly after you've changed the encoding. On the other tabs, you can configure other parameters, including SSH, SSL if necessary. Also, you can save your connections using the Import and Export Settings wizard. This can be convenient in certain situations and can save loads of time. After successful export, delete all connections and import the ones you've saved. As you can see, all the connections we have saved were created afresh. Just download a 30-day free trial version of dbForge Studio for Postgres and find out how easy and effortless it can be to create a database connection.